you have about 45, 50 minutes.
Okay.
And 10 minutes for discussion. Okay.
That'll be just fine. That works out perfectly. All right. My name is David Stroud, and I'm a lecturer of quantitative methods at the business school at Bibb Graves. My background is a computer scientist and data scientist. I am a reinforcement learning researcher, which that's the topic today. That goes along with cue learning and the Markov decision process. I also am a teaching assistant at Southern Methodist University in Dallas. I've been doing that for about a year and a half now, where I teach the machine learning 2 course. And my focus there is teaching students advanced machine learning techniques, which reinforcement learning is one of those that we touch on. And I spend a great deal of time teaching the students about writing code. I'm not a mathematician, but math is one of the most important things that happens in the world of machine learning. We can't do it without math. And some of the most successful people that end up being a data scientist, that end up doing work in artificial intelligence, the basis of it is math. The basis of reinforcement learning, which is a true artificial intelligence in my judgment, is the Markov decision process, which we're going to discuss today, along with the Q learning algorithm. So how we're going to set this up is I'm going to introduce the Q learning algorithm, we're going to talk about the math behind it, discuss the Markov decision process, then we're going to move that into the context of reinforcement learning. The reason why is because reinforcement learning, which I'll talk more about that in just a second, reinforcement learning counts on the math behind the Markov decision process and the math behind Q learning, which is an optimization algorithm, to do what it does. But before we do all of that, can you guys see this right here? Can everyone?
Yes.
Yep. This is a self-driving car. This right here is a self-driving car. It has cameras in the front, and it has a Linux operating system in here. It has a LiDAR to detect different movement. So what I spend the majority of my time doing, and how we're going to describe reinforcement learning, is basing that on using a self-driving car, which just kind of the way that entire process works, and you'll see this in just a moment, but the way that process works is I train, which I'm making sure my model is training because I've got a model for you guys that I'm training. But big picture here, what you do with reinforcement learning with respect to self-driving vehicles, and that's what you just saw right there, was an autonomous vehicle. What you do is build out your Q learning algorithm, your optimization algorithm based on states and actions, and that's optimized over the cloud. And then you take the track that you use on Amazon Web Services, and that converts itself over where the car learns to drive itself. So we're going to talk about that and show the Q learning algorithm in that context. And we're going to also look at the code. Look at the code behind it. Okay, can everybody see a PowerPoint that says Q learning?
Yes.
Okay, let's talk about this for a second. Sorry?
Yes, we can see it. Yes.
Let's talk about this algorithm. Big picture, the Q learning algorithm, or the quality learning algorithm, what you do with that algorithm is you optimize your state action value. Those terms, if you think back to Markov decision processes, where you have a state and an action. To have a state and an action, which you're going to see this personified in a moment with the self-driving car. But what you're doing with the Q learning algorithm is optimizing the process. Bellman, with the Bellman equation, gave us this algorithm. And I'm going to read this directly because it's kind of wordy, it's kind of mouthy. But I'm going to read this directly and then talk about the key learning algorithm. So in the 50s, Bellman found an algorithm to estimate the optimal state action values. These are called Q values or quality values. So the optimum Q value of a state action pair. I enunciate those words because we're going to talk about that a lot. A state action pair, SA, noted Q, and here are your parameters of SA or state action. That's the sum of the discounted future rewards that the agent can expect on average after it reaches the state and chooses an action, but before it sees the outcome of the action. And this all assumes that it acts in an optimal fashion. That's kind of a wordy definition right there, but we're going to see that we're going to see how that fits in to reinforcement learning, because reinforcement learning, which again I'm going to describe in just a second, but self-driving cars use this algorithm, this Q learning algorithm that optimizes it. Actually, the Q learning algorithm, that's where it starts, but it moves into, because the Q learning algorithm is too hard to train, what you have to use is the DQN, deep learning Q network, which it takes deep learning to do that. And I'm about to show an example of deep learning in just a little bit. But let's look at this equation here. So we have Q, and then we have S sub T and A sub T. So Q, the new Q algorithm, or the new Q function here, we have S of T, A of T, state, action, and of course the T is time, because this is sequential. It's moving in either a discrete or a continuous fashion, depending on what you're actually analyzing. So to optimize the algorithm, here's the formula. And the cool thing is, I'm not sure, where is this group right here? I'm not sure how much time you guys spend writing software if you use Python, but really what in my world, what I spend the majority of time doing is putting this right here, putting this math here into something that looks like this. Okay, so everything that in that formula you saw right there, basically in Python code, this is how it's written out. That's how I would write it out in Python and actually run the software. We'll come back to that in just a second. So here's the equation here. We have the old value, and again, go back to the definition with Markov decision processes and with Q learning and with reinforcement learning, you're going to constantly hear me talking about a state, an action, and a reward. So to do the Q learning algorithm, this is not the deep Q algorithm, but just the Q learning algorithm. We have the old state. We have the old state here, and you add that to the learning rate, and then you multiply that times this here. So this is the old value here, and here's the new value here, where you have the reward, adding it to the discount factor, which is multiplied by the estimate of the optimal future value. And then you take the old value, you subtract the old value. So using this formula, you get a Q score. Different than you want a higher Q score, whereas in traditional machine learning, you want to get a lower root mean squared error, okay? With Q learning, you're trying to get a higher score. So this is what the algorithm looks like here. Old value, well, this is what the math equation looks like. Old value plus the learning rate, which is determined, you could optimize that using some type of a grid search, times a reward plus a discount factor. Discount factor, we'll talk about that just a little bit more, and then multiply that times the optimal future value. So what you do is you'll take this algorithm here, take the math, and turn it into an algorithm that looks like this in Python, where you run a Q value algorithm. And you can kind of see right here, let me split this up a little bit. can't see that as well. That's okay. But notice here, you can, sorry, that keeps dancing away. There we go. So you can kind of see right here, if you have, you can see where the math here and then the algorithm here, how basically I've taken that math there and turned it into code. And that's kind of the guts of the way you would use use Q-learning. Okay. Now let's talk a moment about the Markov decision process. And I've always felt like reinforcement learning does a really good job of taking the abstract, because again, really, when you put code into action, a lot of times I think people would say, well, something like the Markov decision is too abstract. We actually can't. It's more theoretical than anything else. We in the reinforcement learning arena would disagree with that, and we would say we can't do what we want to do without the Markov decision process. And I'll just go over what that is again. I know everybody here. This is a mathy group, so you guys already understand the way this understand the Markov decision process. So the Markov decision process, only the present matters, meaning that past behavior is not included in the future movements. So in the Markov property, the current state completely characterizes a state of the world. And again, back to the similar nomenclature here that you saw in the Q learning algorithm. S is a set of possible states. A is a set of possible actions. R is a distribution of the reward given for the state action pair. And then the transition probability considers a distribution of the next state action pair. And then you have a discount factor where
All right, thank you.
Thank you, guys.
See you next week.
Thank you.
I'll stay in touch. Bye-bye.
Bye, everybody.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.